हरिओम। श्री गणेशाय नमः। ओम श्री हिरण्यगर्भाय नमः। ओम श्री महाविष्णवे नमः। ओम श्री महादेवाय नमः। ओम श्री महादुर्गायै नमः। ओम श्री राम रामाय नमः। ओम श्री सद्गुरवे नमः। ओम सहना भवतु, सहनौ भुनक्तु, सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुरेव परब्रह्मा तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। समस्तजनकल्याणे निरतं करुणामयं नमामि चिन्मयं देवं सद्गुरुं ब्रह्मविद्वरं भवानी शंकरो वंदे श्रद्धा विश्वासरूपिणौ याभ्यां विना न पश्यन्ति सिद्धा स्वान्तस्तमीश्वरं वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमर्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं रामाय रामभद्राय रामचंद्राय वेदसे रघुनाथाय नाथाय सीताया पतये नमः। बुद्धिर्बलं यशो धैर्यं निर्भयत्वमरोगतां अजाड्यं वाक्पटुत्वञ्च हनुमत्स्मरणाद् भवेत्। शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशंकरं लोकशंकरं सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम नमः शिवाय। 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 नमः पार्वती पतये। हर हर महादेव। हरि ओम। हरि ओम। सो भगवान इज describing the karmas of the four varnas. ब्राह्मण क्षत्रिय वैश्य एंड शूद्र द होल वर्ल्ड इज एन एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ भगवान्स प्रकृति. भगवान अलोन एज हिज प्रकृति इज एक्सप्रेसिंग एज दिस वर्ल्ड. भगवान्स प्रकृति इज त्रिगुणात्मिका. सो ऑल द एक्सप्रेशंस have these three gunas in them, and all the living beings, they express these three gunas in their body, in their actions, in their mind, in their thinking, in the results which they gain. So based on these gunas and karmas, the four types of human beings are being classified. Chaturvarnyam maya srishtam guna karma vibhagashah. So based on the gunas and karmas, the four varnas are there. And we are born with a particular predominant guna or the proportion of these gunas. So based on that we have our varna. And based on our varna, there are certain karmas which are best suitable for us. So, Bhagavan says, those who are Brahmana, for them, the karma, shama, dhamma, tapas, shaucham, kshantir, arjavam, ज्ञानम विज्ञानमास्तिक्यम और ब्रह्म कर्म स्वभावजम. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर स्वभाव, अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर संस्कार ऑफ द प्रीवियस लाइफ विथ विच दे आर बॉर्न, सो द बेस्ट कर्म फॉर देम टू नॉट ओनली लिव इन दिस वर्ल्ड बट ऑल्सो प्रोग्रेस स्पिरिचुअली इज टू कल्टिवेट द क्वालिटीज लाइक क्षम, दैट इज क्वाइटिट्यूड ऑफ द माइंड, Dhamma, that is control over all the senses, then tapas, physical tapas, vachik tapas, mansik tapas, which they can pursue, then shaucham, cleanliness, then kshanti, kshama, forgiveness. They practice forgiveness. And arjavam, being straightforward. Then jnanam, pursue acquiring knowledge. Knowledge is revealed in the shastras. And also vijnanam, the experience of this knowledge. Astikyam, and they have this natural shraddha in the shastras. So the one who is Brahmana, who has got this Sattvagun Pradhan, they have this natural inclination towards knowledge, and their Antakkarana is relatively calm and peaceful. So even if they use their intelligence in the world, in the field of science, in the field of politics, in the field of teaching and doing research, in the field of judiciary, they can shine, they can excel. So that is the best way of expressing, because when we express our samskar, the mind start becoming more and more pure, and one becomes fit for gaining that supreme knowledge and that goal of moksha. So after explaining the karmas of Brahmana, now in the next verse, verse number 43, Bhagavan describes the karma of a kshatriya. So let us chant. शौर्यं तेजो धृतिर्दाक्ष्यं युद्धे चाप्य पलायनम दानम ईश्वर भावश्च क्षत्र कर्म स्वभावजम। भगवान सेज द क्षत्र कर्म स्वभावजम, दिस आर द कर्मास ऑफ द क्षत्रियस विच आर स्वभावजम, मीन्स स्वभाव प्रभव गुण ही, दे आर बॉर्न दे अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर स्वभाव, दैट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर प्रीडोमिनेंट गुणास। सो क्षत्रिय विल हैव प्रीडोमिनेंट रजोगुण एंड बैक्ड बाय सत्व गुण। सो रजोगुण इज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी, लॉट ऑफ पावर एंड लॉट ऑफ इवन डिजायर्स आर देयर एंड एक्टिविटी attachment, but since it is backed by sattvagun, all the positive qualities of the rajogun will get expressed. So a person will become more generous, more compassionate, will have a holistic approach to life, will be very sacrificing, and will do everything to safeguard others, protect others, and create order and discipline in the society. So kshatriya, a good kshatriya can be a good king, can be a good warrior, can be a good soldier, or a police officer defending the people, defending the country, and creating, maintaining law and order. So all these qualities are very helpful for performing this type of work. So Bhagwan says shauryam, one of their main quality which they have to, which is potentially there and which they have to cultivate also, that is shaurya. Shaurya is courage. Courage is to face different challenges, not be afraid of any obstacles, to move forward in life, overcoming all difficulties, that bravery, that is one of the most fascinating quality of a kshatriya. So shaurya, not afraid. Some of these qualities we see in the animals also, very fierce, fearless, facing all challenges. So shaurya. Then tej. Tej is a brilliance on the personality of that person, which comes because of his bravery, because of his deep faith in righteousness, in goodness, in order, in compassion. So that shows on the personality of a kshatriya. It's very tejasvi. Tejaha, royal. Then dhritihi. Dhriti is perseverance. शंकराचार्य जी राइट्स कि धारणम सर्व अवस्थासु, दैट वॉट एवर बी द सिचुएशन, हाव एवर डिफिकल्ट, हाव एवर व्हाट कॉल डेंजरस सिचुएशन, दे विल रिमेन फर्म ऑन देयर पाथ, दे विल रिमेन फर्म इन देयर ड्यूटी, विल नॉट रन अवे, दे विल परस्यू इट effort with full effort and energy and enthusiasm, never give up attitude. That is the dharana shakti, dhritihi. So dhritihi, without getting tired or lazy, anavasado bhavati, yaya dhritya uttam bitasya, will not have any dejection, depression in any situation, will remain firm. And that is a very important quality for Kshatriya, because sometimes in the society, in the nation, difficult situation arises, some emergency situation, they have to face all the challenges very bravely. See, in our country we have the history of such brave Kshatriyas, great kings. Like in Maharashtra, we had this great king Shivaji Maharaj. All these qualities of a great Kshatriya we could see in Shivaji Maharaj. He had that genuine faith and respect for his teacher, Samartha Ramdas Swamiji. And he followed the path of dharma properly, taking care of his subjects, never deviating from his path. Very brave, very courageous. And he had an equally courageous son, Shambhaji Maharaj. So such brave Kshatriyas, they really could change the very history of our country due to their bravery, due to their governance. They had ruled this Maratha kingdom, was there ruling the almost great part of our country for a long time. And they could face the challenges of the invaders, stop them on their path at various places. So we have the story of great kings and queens also, who had shown such exceptional courage. See, the Kshatriya, not only man, but Kshatriya woman, were also brave and courageous, and they also used to have weapons in their hands. They were not coward, but they used to go into the battlefield also. There is a story of Kaikeyi, who went in the battlefield and protected her husband, Dashrath Maharaj. Great queens like Rani Lakshmibai and so many others, they had exceptional strength and power and courage. And this is there in our history. It is there in their blood, that courage and prowess is there in the blood of the Kshatriyas. Great generosities, compassion towards all, not exploiting people, not using power for their own selfish interest, but genuinely for the welfare of the world. That is the natural sign of a Kshatriya. Not a Kshatriya for namesake. Not a Kshatriya contaminated with tamogun. Kshatriya with rajogun and sattvagun. Like Guru Gobind Singh. Great spiritual master, but also a great warrior, defending the dharma, protecting those who are weak and could not face the torments of the offenders. Such bravery we can see is a natural expression of a kshatriya. The kshatriya blood is there, which has to be developed, which has to be brought out. So this, when we do our karma according to our gunas, those things will come out in full measure. In our country, we have communities, we have races who are kshatriyas, and we hear stories of their bravery in the battlefield, in every field. Tremendous courage and power and force and strength. Amazing. Cannot be suppressed in any way. See, in Mahabharata we have story of Karna. Karna was born to Kunti, a Kshatriya. But he was then abandoned in his childhood itself and was raised by charioteer. But the Kshatriya blood was there within. That Kshatriya guna, he was born with the Kshatriya. So destiny brought him in contact with Duryodhana, and he became a king of Angaraj, Ang Desh, and he fought bravely in this Mahabharata war. Unfortunately, he did not know in the beginning that he was a son of Kunti and had terrible outcome also, but the Kshatriya spirit was there in him. Same Kshatriya we can see in Arjuna, in Yudhishthira, in Bhim, Nakul, Sahadev. So this is a very important quality. So Dhritihi and Daksham. Daksham means dakshata, alertness. Dakshasya bhavah sahasa prati utpanneshu karyeshu avyamohena pravruttihi. Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji says that when certain situation comes suddenly, they know how to, they can judge the situation and know how to face it. See, during war also, situation can change instantaneously. They have to assess the situation and accordingly decide what to do. They have to judge in case of emergency and all. They know how to deal with the situation. We hear the stories of soldiers and warriors. They face different challenges. Even in our recent time, our soldiers have fought so bravely against our neighboring enemies and won great battles through their bravery, through their intelligence and planning and strategies. So all this is the quality of a Kshatriya which he has to develop also. So it's called Daksham, Dakshata. Ever ready to face any situation and is able to efficiently face different situation also. And yuddhecha api apalayanam. Another quality is that in the battlefield or when a war-like situation comes, they never turn their back. They don't go away. They don't run away from battlefield. Aparang mukhi bhavah shatrubhyah. They don't show their back to their enemies. Don't run away from obstacles, situation, war, dharmic war, like Arjuna was trying to do here. It was against his kshatriya dharma. against his natural spontaneous dharma. He said, I don't want to fight this war. Bhagavan said, this is what you are doing is anaryam, ajustam, aswargya, swargyam. That what you are doing is not proper. So yuddhe cha api apalayanam. That capacity is there in a soldier, in a kshatriya, not to run away from any obstacles. See, all the time there may not be war, but there are situations which are difficult in our life. So kshatriya is able to face and overcome all situations in his life also, without getting depressed, without getting upset, without losing hope, without giving up in any way. Then danam, deyeshu muktahastata, another great quality which is natural in a kshatriya is that dana means very generous, shares whatever he has with others. Muktahastata, freely gives dana. Whoever comes and asks for something, they will never say no, will give. According to their whatever ability, they will share. Again, in Karna, this was one of his most wonderful quality. He was a great danveer. Never said no to anyone who asked for anything from him. Suryaputra, Karna. So Indra Bhagwan came to him and asked for kavach and kundalam. He was born with kavach, a natural armor, and a kundal. And with that natural armor, it was no weapon could penetrate it. And if he had that armor, no one would have defeated him. Arjuna was no match for him. Very brave, very talented. And Indra Bhagwan came and asked for this kavach and kundala. And he said, okay, take it, take them. He just removed and gave it to him. So dana, loyalty, compassion, friendship. So danam deyeshu mukta hastata, ishvara bhava, lordship. Natural, they have this leadership quality, lordship in them. Wherever they are, they can form an army, they can form a group, they can create a force. They have this natural ability. From simple folks also, they can create an army and fight the enemies like anything. Like we had Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. He created a powerful army to fight the enemies. That ability, that lordship is called Ishvara Bhava. These are the natural qualities in this Kshatriya. It's a natural quality of Rajogun and Sattvagun, which we have to harness. If we have them, we have to harness them for the welfare of the world. The Brahmana should harness his quality for the welfare of the world. Kshatriya should harness his quality for the welfare of this world. All these qualities are good for the world. Welfare of the world. Even a Vaishya and Shudra have got these qualities, amazing qualities, which if they are harnessed, is good for the world. Everything is positive and nice. But if they are not harnessed properly, then they can be very, very terrible for the world. A bad Brahmana can create disturbance in the whole society. A bad Kshatriya can again harm the society. A bad Vaishya, a bad Shudra can be very harmful to the balance of this society. So here Bhagavan is talking about how we recognize our gunas, recognize our varna, and bring out the best for the welfare of the world as well as for our own progress. And when all these four varnas together, when they work towards one supreme goal, the whole society progress. Everything, there is a what you call the Ram Rajya. Everyone lives in peace and harmony. Everyone progresses. There is no sorrow, there is no pain. See, one of the most important thing about this Varnashram Dharma is that everyone's work is predetermined, means there is a job security, you can say. You don't have to worry what type of work I have to do, how I should maintain myself, my livelihood. A Brahmana, as I said, is taken care of by the Dakshina which he gets, the donation, the charity. The Kshatriyas get the taxes from the people to maintain the law and order in the society for good governance. So all those who are working for the king and all these to be taken care of through these taxes. Like nowadays we have the government and the government servants and all. And the Vaishyas will create their own wealth. They are self-employed. They can create their own wealth and also employ others. So, danam ishvara bhavascha, ishvara bhav, very beautiful quality, prabhu shakti prakati karanam ishitavyan prati. It shows that lordship and leadership quality towards all those whom he leads. These are kshatra karma swabhavajam, these are the karmas of a Kshatriya, swabhavik karma, natural karma, which may remain hidden, may remain dormant, may not be expressed fully. So, Kshatriya should try to express this, all these gunas while living in this world and for the welfare of the society, should express these gunas. See, as I gave the example of the metals also, like gold. Gold has got its own quality. Gold has its own property. So if I am gold, I should try to express my property, my talent. Which can be used to make ornaments or used in some other field also. If I am iron, I should bring out that iron quality in full measure. If I am steel, I should bring out that steel quality. If I am copper, then I should bring out that copper quality. Similarly, if I am Kshatriya, Vaishya, Brahmana, Kshudra, those qualities should be enhanced. बिकॉज वेन आई ब्रिंग देम आउट इट विल गिव मी ग्रेटेस्ट जॉय. देर इज ग्रेट जॉय इन क्रिएटिविटी. क्रिएटिविटी इज एक्सप्रेसिंग योर इनरमोस्ट टैलेंट्स, योर इनरमोस्ट नेचुरल स्पॉन्टेनियस क्वालिटीज. इट विल गिव यू ग्रेट जॉय. देन वर्क, वट एवर वर्क वी डू अकॉर्डिंग टू अवर गुणास विल नॉट बी रियली वर्क, विल बी अ ग्रेट एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ अवर जॉय, ऑफ अवर लव. फॉर अ क्षत्रिय इट इज नॉट अ वर्क टू लिव एज अ क्षत्रिय. फॉर अ ब्राह्मण इट इज नॉट अ वर्क. फॉर अ वैश्य शूद्र इट विल नॉट बी अ वर्क. बट वेन वी सप्रेस अवर नेचुरल टेंडेंसीज एंड ट्राई टू इमिटेट समवन एल्स, वेन वी डू अधर्म और परधर्म, निग्लेक्ट अवर ओन क्वालिटीज, देन दैट इज नॉट गुड. सो दिस इज द कर्म ऑफ अ क्षत्रिय. नाउ इन द नेक्स्ट वर्स भगवान डिस्क्राइब्स द नेचुरल कर्म ऑफ अ वैश्य एंड अ शूद्र. ही सेज कृषि गौरक्ष वाणिज्यम वैश्यकर्म स्वभावजम परिचर्यात्मकम कर्म शूद्रस्यापि स्वभावजम. भगवान सेज दैट वैश्यकर्म स्वभावजम कृषि गौरक्ष वाणिज्यम. कृषि मीन्स टिलिंग द सॉइल, मीन्स एग्रीकल्चर, एग्रीकल्चर. देन गौरक्ष, गौरक्ष मीन्स प्रोटेक्टिंग द काउज एंड वाणिज्य. वाणिज्य मीन्स ट्रेड, बाइंग एंड सेलिंग. सी दिस, ऑल दिस थ्री आर द नेचुरल कर्म ऑफ अ वैश्य. वैश्य इज वन हु ऑल्सो हैज गॉट लॉट ऑफ रजोगुण, मीन्स लॉट ऑफ एनर्जी, डिजायर्स, एम्बिशंस, बैक्ड बाय तमोगुण, द स्टेइंग पावर, लिटिल लेथार्जी एंड ऑल, बट तमोगुण इज देयर एंड लिटिल बिट ऑफ सत्वगुण. सो विद दिस क्वालिटीज द पर्सन इज बेस्ट सूटेड फॉर एग्रीकल्चर, ब्रिंगिंग आउट दैट वेल्थ फ्रॉम अवर अर्थ एंड फॉर गोरक्ष, सी प्रोटेक्टिंग द काउस. In our country, in all our shastras, great emphasis is laid on the importance of cow and the protection of cow. Very important. See, cow gives milk. Cow also gives bull. The bull is used for farming and for agriculture purpose. And the cow's milk is a great food for everyone. And also everything which the cow gives was used. The cow dung, the urine, the milk. It was used direct consumption also. Also used in all the rituals. So whether a person is following the path of dharma, I mean the rituals, or doing some worldly karma, the cow is to be like a blessing. And milk of the cow is considered most medicinal, because cow is the only one of the rare being who can eat and digest grass. Other beings who eat the grass, the grass comes out in the same way. It is not fully digested. But cow can digest the grass completely. And grass has got tremendous medicinal value. Even Lord Ganesha, he loves grass, durva and all. So protecting the cow is one of the most important, taking care of the cow was important dharma of a Vaishya. Killing a cow or hurting the cow is considered to be a great sin. Nowadays in Kali Yuga, so much of thing has happened. People are hurting the cows, killing them, eating them, torturing them. So all these things are happening. Even those who are born in a Vaishya family, they also involve themselves in this business of selling, killing cows and selling their meat and all those things, which is total adharma and papa. So Gauraksha. Gauraksha, Gau is also a symbol of wealth. And Gauraksha is protecting the wealth, means like banking and all. So a Vaishya is also best suited for banking, for protecting wealth and also giving loans. And they used to give loans even to the kings. If any emergency situation is there in the country, the Vaishyas used to help by giving loan even to the kings. So banking and all. And Vanijya. Vanijya is trade, buying and selling goods. So circulating the wealth and circulating the goods keeps the whole nation healthy. Just like in our body, when the blood gets circulated, when the food juices get circulated, when our oxygen which we breathe in gets circulated, we remain healthy. Similarly, when the wealth gets circulated properly, the nation remains healthy. So that is the Vanijya. So all these three are in together in that Vaishya. Farming, business, trade, banking, all hand in hand together. So Vaishya Karma Swabhavajam. Then the most important and one of the most necessary work is offered by those who are Shudra. Paricharyatmakam karma Shudrasyapi Swabhavajam. Service, to provide the services at all levels. See, Shudra is having that tamogun predominant with little bit of rajogun and sattvagun. Here one should understand that Shudra doesn't mean a totally foolish or ignorant or uneducated person. Shudra can be very intelligent, very wise, very, what you call, can be in the... Because that intelligence, there are two types of buddhi. One buddhi is sukshma buddhi, we call it. And another is tikshna buddhi. Tikshna buddhi means sharp intellect. Sukshma buddhi means subtle intellect. See, when our antakarana becomes more and more pure, when there is sattvagun, then there is more awareness of our self take place. We become more aware of our own inner self as the mind becomes more and more pure. But when the mind is not pure, we are not so much aware of our innermost self. But a person is not totally dull, is sharp enough to understand the different things of this world. May not have a subtle intellect, but may have a sharp intellect to understand the different strategies and all. So there are those workers who are so very efficient and clever and come up with great inventions also and have the ability. See, some of this our great workers have really discovered different metals and how to prepare different utensils and all. Even here in Delhi we have that pillar in the Qutub area, that Qutub Minar place, which is made up of iron, but that iron doesn't rust. So goldsmith, ironsmith, tailors, masons, engineers, all this field are required to make our life easy in this world. And it requires great intelligence to be a skilled worker. Skilled worker. Skill is required in all field. So that is the natural ability of those who have this quality, the tamogun, the shudra. They have this great skill and natural ability of doing certain work which are very helpful for everyone. In our in Upanishad, in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, in a very story form, the whole this varnas are described. That in the beginning only the Brahmanas were there, and they wanted to do the yajna, but they could not do because there was nobody to protect them. Then the Kshatriyas were born who could protect the yajna and this karma. But still the work could not be done because no resources were there, no wealth was there. Then the Vaishyas were born and all the wealth and resources they came. But still that work could not be done, the balance of the society was not maintained. Could not be maintained. Then the Shudra was born and everything got streamlined. So all these four varnas are necessary for a good maintenance or for good flow of the society. In our country, in our tradition, this we have named them. The Shastras have named Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. But whichever societies are there in the world, those who have forgotten their Chaturvarna, they also have these four Varnas. May not be named in that way, but every country, every nation will have those who are the thinkers, those who create laws, those who judge, those who use their intelligence to share their knowledge with others. Then there are those who are the administrators, the governing bodies, the defense, the warriors. Then there are those who create wealth, the producers, the business class, the farmers, those who create wealth. And then there are those workers who work at all levels. Means workers are there helping the Brahmanas, the Kshatriyas, the Vaishyas. Workers are required at all levels to make things move forward. So we have to understand this Chaturvarna properly. And here Bhagwan is not mentioned, but our Shastra also mentioned the four ashramas. So when we are born, in the beginning, we leave the Brahmacharya ashram, in which we have to study, we have to gain knowledge, we have to gain knowledge of dharma. Thereafter, we get married and live the life of a grahasthi, have children, get them married, teach them the path of dharma, and then a person enters the vanaprastha ashram, lives a life of tapas, developing all the qualities required for gaining that supreme knowledge. And after gaining that self-knowledge, then enters the sannyas ashram, wherein spends his time in nididhyasan, gaining abidance in that supreme self and attaining moksha. So the whole agenda, the purpose of the society is to lead everyone towards moksha while maintaining law and order and harmony in the world around us. So this is what it is. So after describing the karma, natural karma of these four varna, see, when it is said that a kshudra having a tamogun, and tamogun is nidra, alas, pramad, it doesn't mean the natural karma for a kshudra is to keep on sleeping or being lazy. The natural karma which Bhagwan has mentioned here for a kshudra to progress in his life is seva. To spend his time in services, in whatever field of his liking, whichever field. Similarly, a Vaishya should express his talent in creativity, in producing, in being self-employed, in employing others. A Kshatriya can express in protecting and governing, etc. So after describing this, now in the next verse, Bhagwan tells the purpose of description of all this. What is it? He says, Sve sve karmanyabhiratah samsiddhim labhate narah svakarma niratah siddhim yathavindati tashrunu. Bhagwan says that when we perform our karma according to our varna and ashrama sincerely, then it purifies our antakkarana. Also, we acquire a lot of punya, and we can our next life becomes good. We can attain svarga or attain a better life in future. But if we perform this our swadharma, means our karma according to our guna, according to our varna and ashrama, dedicating to Ishvara, it leads to Chitta Shuddhi and makes us fit for self-knowledge. So that's what Bhagwan says, ki sve sve karmani abhiratah. Remaining firm and remaining devoted and dedicated to one's own work based on our varna and ashrama, Bhagavan says, sam siddhim labhate naraha, a person, a human being, gain sam siddhi. Sam siddhi means gain adhikar for gaining moksha. Shankaracharya ji writes, ki swakarma anushtanad ashuddhi kshaye sati kaya indriyanam jnana nishtha yogyata lakshanam siddhim labhate. That when we perform our action dedicating to Ishvara, our antakarana becomes pure and we become fit to pursue the path of jnana nishtha, that is nididhyasan, and gain freedom from this samsara. So svakarma nirata siddhim yatha vindati tat shrunu. So how can we utilize our swadharma to gain chitta shuddhi and then gain jnana nishtha? That Bhagavan says, I will tell you how to do it. Svakarma nirata siddhim yatha vindati tat shrunu. You listen how you can gain that siddhi. Siddhi means how you can gain the ability to do your nididhyasan, do that jnana nishtha through your karma, that technique, you listen from me. And that Bhagavan will tell further. This shloka also, we will see it again in our class, next class, and see the other shlokas also. Very beautiful shlokas are there that we will see in our next class. Tomorrow is a very auspicious day. It's called Shivaratri, Maha Shivaratri. So tomorrow we will not have this class, but instead of that we will have Shivaratri Puja. But that Shivaratri Puja will be in the evening, 5:30. So at 5:30, tomorrow at 5:30 in the evening, we will have Shivaratri Puja. You can participate online. So we will have from 5:30 onwards, we will have that puja. During the day you can observe whatever ritual you do, and also if you can chant Bhagavan's beautiful mantra Om Namah Shivaya, that is very good. And observe, if you can observe some fasting and remembering, meditating on Lord Shiva, chanting some mantras and doing some other upasanas, japa, it will be good. So we shall meet again tomorrow in the evening at 5:30 for Shivaratri, Mahashivaratri Puja. And we will continue with this class day after tomorrow. So on Friday, we will continue with our class. Hari Om. So till then, you take care, be happy, safe, peaceful, healthy. Do your work, do your sadhana, and contemplate on what you have heard. And we shall meet again tomorrow evening at 5:30 for Mahashivratri Puja. Hari Om. Shri Ram Jaya Ram Jaya Jaya Ram. 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 श्री राम जय जय राम, 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 श्री राम जय राम, श्री राम जय राम, जय राम, जय राम। बोलिए शिव रामचंद्र भगवान की जय। ओम पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरिः ओम। श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः। हरिः ओम।